This is Lincoln, the channel for Higher Self, and welcome to the Satsang with the Self video series. In today's Satsang video, I will speak upon the process of purification, of cleansing the mind, body, and emotions, and how during this process of purification, the body and the personal ego can resist this process to hold on to its own identity and its own control. During this video, I will talk about techniques that the ego uses to sabotage the process of healing, and also ways that you, as a conscious being, can recognize the ego and better remove it, better purify it, so that you can create greater happiness and greater health. I hope you enjoy today's Satsang with the Self session. Dear ones, look around you and look within you, for that is how you will find how you are perceiving this world, how you are perceiving yourself, and that is how you will understand how the ego is constructing your version of reality. The ego, dear one, is your sense of a personal self. It is your collection of ideas and beliefs about who you are, and it goes far deeper than the auditory thoughts within your mind. It goes far deeper than the perceptions that you currently see and accept as part of yourself. Understand, dear one, from that the moment of time when you first stepped foot upon this earth, your ego was being formed. The ego was formed by all that you saw, all that you felt, all that you heard. The collection of information gathered from your five senses and gathered from your own inner interpretation of these senses, began to construct the person you believe yourself to be here and now. The ego, dear one, is your sense of a personal self. It is your idea of a personal self. It is the belief of who you are, and also of how this world operates. You see, dear ones, in reality, you yourself are pure consciousness. All that you see around you is nothing more than vibration within the consciousness. All that you see around you is forever changing, forever unstable, forever without a solid identity. And yet the ego personality forms a belief of a solid person, of a solid world, and it interacts with the reality, with the subjective reality, in this way. For the ego believes that the future will continue as it has always done. The ego believes that your future is under your own personal control and influence. The ego believes that who you are right now is who you made yourself to be. The ego believes that it has control over something that is ultimately outside of its control. So you see, dear one, as we look upon the structure and foundation of the ego itself, we see many core beliefs that are not based upon the objective experience of reality, but rather they are based upon the subjective beliefs that the ego has empowered to become its own version of truth. This is why, dear ones, when you interact within this world, there is such a range of human personalities, such a range in the way that humans operate within this world, and the way humans interpret this world, the way they interpret the lives and actions of others, the way they view their life, the goals they create. And so you see, dear one, each and every ego has its own free will choice of how it wishes to interpret this neutral world, this objective world of change, to form its own self-identity. It is far more than self-image, for it is in fact the interpretation of how this world is, of who oneself is, of what life is. This, dear ones, is how deep the ego's image goes. So when you try through purification practices to remove parts of this dysfunctional interpretation, the ego often reacts. Dear ones, understand that the ego creates an identity that it believes to be stable. And so when something shakes the foundation of this stability, the ego reacts in fear. Fear of its own survival. Fear of its self-preservation, of the belief structure that it has created. For the ego has created this structure to provide safety in a world that it believes it fears. The ego has created this structure to find stability in a world that is forever changing, forever in a state of chaos, but organized chaos. Yet it is the chaos that the ego fears itself. It is the change that the ego fears within. And it is by creating a synthetic, stabilized structure of belief and identity that it brings some type of control over a world that is ultimately outside of the ego's control. And so, dear one, when you attempt to cleanse this foundation, this structure that the ego has created, the ego reacts in fear. The ego then begins to take action within your perception. For all actions are within the perception of your own being. And this is how you will watch the ego. This is how you will understand the ego. The ego takes action to preserve itself, dear one, by affecting you, by manipulating you, by controlling you. And it is through the actions of controlling your perception, controlling your energy system, controlling your thoughts and your words. It is through the ego's control over you that it then convinces you and directs you to use your free will energy, to use your action to manipulate the external world, to manipulate others. And it does this with the one sole purpose, to maintain its own control, to maintain its own foundation, to secure its own structure. For it is within this structure that the ego has its entire identity. And so when this structure is threatened, then, dear ones, the ego will react against you. Understand that the way we see yourself is a collection of various energies. Energies under your control and influence in a limited way. For these energies are ultimately provided by the supreme source of all life. And yet as they pass through your being, you have control over how you wish to influence their flow, their direction. You are able to control your actions to direct this energy in new ways. You are able to control your thoughts to direct this energy in new ways. You are able to control your emotions to direct this energy in new ways. But often we feel that we do not have control of our mind, emotions, and body. And this, dear one, is because something else within you has control over them.